please be seated. Today is the vigil, the quiet, prayerful day of preparation for one of the great feast days of the year, the feast day of St. James the Greater, who in turn is one of the three of the greatest of the 12 apostles. Tomorrow is his feast day itself. Today we commemorate St. Christina, virgin and martyr, the third collect of our Blessed Lady. After Mass, we begin our preparation for the great feast, great because it falls on a Sunday this year, of St. Anne, the mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. So we open our Triduum devotions to St. Anne after the last Gospel. And then, as usual, we conclude with the benediction of the Blessed Sacrament after the novena to the Sacred Heart. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. Have you ever had the experience, and it happens to us all the time, that someone says something to you or writes something, and you think to yourself, now he doesn't really know what he's talking about, or you would say, so such and such a situation isn't quite as he imagines that it is. Of course, only the good God can see and judge every person and situation and know perfectly the truth of a matter. It's curious, though, isn't it? But that never does stop anybody from offering his opinion, even though our opinion is worse than useless sometimes. It's worse than useless, I mean, because if it causes us to commit a sin and to offend the good Lord, we would have done much better to keep silent. And in much speaking, thou canst not avoid sin, Scripture says, and St. Benedict, in his rule for monks, quotes this wise truth of God's word. I think of this today because today we commemorate St. Christina. And centuries ago, when the Masonic Antichrist movement was just getting ahead, I mean in the 18th century, when already people thought they knew everything and far better than Holy Mother Church, there were many who said, well, that's just a myth. St. Christina never existed, you see. And then, in the 19th century, much to everyone's surprise, this saint, who back then they dismissed as made up, as they have done today about good St. Christopher, who comes tomorrow, by then, what happened was this. She was a martyr in northern Italy, near the place where the great Eucharistic miracle, the miracle of the host of Bolsena, would one day take place. And the part of the lake of Bolsena receded during a drought. There wasn't enough rain. And it revealed in the lake, which had been covered by water for centuries, the catacomb and the shrine of St. Christina. And all these people said, oh, it wasn't true. But it was true. And they were, by scientific evidence, forced into silence. Imagine what people would say if we had in our midst today another Saint Christina, whom we honor on the calendar, once or twice some of the girls for the All Saints Day procession have dressed themselves up as her. Saint Christina the Astonishing. What would one say about her? One would tend, I suppose, most Catholics to dismiss her as crazy or perhaps possessed by the devil. And yet she was a saint who came back to life from death. She had been in purgatory, and she was allowed to spend her purgatory on earth, doing wonderful things. She came to life at the Agnus Dei of her Requiem Mass. And then, because she had been in eternity, she had such an intolerance for sin, the stench of sin she could not bear, she flew up from her coffin, right there in the church, to the rafters of the ceiling. And she stayed there for the rest of the Mass. She couldn't bear the stench of sin. She was always doing astonishing things. She lived as a beggar. She wore rags. She barely ate anything. She said the most astonishing things and did them. And sometimes people would try to capture her or chain her up or things like that. But she was a true supernatural case, as it were. It was God's will. She was a soul who had come back from purgatory to prove the truth of it and in her own life to expiate for her sins, as well as the sins of others. Sometimes she would lead souls from purgatory to heaven, or from this life, the deathbed, down into the flames of purgatory. And everyone dismissed her almost. But back then, that was the age of faith. It was the High Middle Ages. And the saint who wrote the Blessed James of Verragine, a Dominican bishop, who wrote so many of the lives of the saints in the book called The Golden Legend, he had personal experience of her, and he wrote all about Christina the Astonishing. We should always be careful to be silent before that which astonishes us, surprises us, or seems unlikely to us, rather than to express an opinion. Because in silence, no one ever commits a sin, but in much speaking, thou canst not avoid sin. Now, our Blessed Mother, because she is the Mother of God, the Queen of angels and of men, was able to avoid, by her miraculous command, many a situation in life which would have caused people to talk out of order or out of place. Tomorrow, St. James was, after St. John, her favorite of the 12 apostles. Yet our Blessed Mother, who is the most prudent queen, as we read in the mystical City of God, knew that if she showed any favor at all to this one, the other apostles would do what? They would talk. They would jump to conclusions. They would criticize. They would feel hurt and jealous. So the most prudent virgin, rather than showing any external signs of special affection for St. James the Greater, brother of St. John, who received her into his home after Good Friday, Our Lady would rather appear privately to him. So it was only between the Blessed Mother and St. James. And the other apostles, of course, he never said a word, nor did she, so they never got wind of it. And so Our Lady then was able to avoid, by her discretion and by her prudence, quite a bit of carrying on and talking that would otherwise take place. Let us ask our Blessed Mother, every time we pick up her beads, every time we cross ourselves to pray, every time we come into the sanctuary of Almighty God, the Church, let us ask Our Lady to put a seal upon our lips so that all of those things that we perhaps can't and do not certainly fully understand now, one day may be made clear to us. In the meantime, think of this. Our Lady is willing to appear to each one of us, to speak with us, to answer our prayers, and to accompany us. We are, for her, her only and her favorite child. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.